They woke up. Thank goodness. Feel any different? Did you notice? I left the duct tape at home. I said I left the duct tape, not any of the ropes. You're being a little bit too loud, okay? I know you locked all the windows and all the doors. Isn't that obvious? It's not that hard to pick a lock. You think I'd let a door stay in the way between our love? You're so silly. I'm serious. This is a trial run, so if you keep yelling, the next time I won't forget to bring the duct tape. You don't mean that. Stop saying I'm crazy. Stop. Or else you're gonna find out what crazy really looks like. Good. You know, you're loud by nature. You were always sort of quiet in class, but watching you further, anyone could see that's not the case. Is your final warning. If you yell every word you say, I'm gonna do something that you'll regret. Are you kidding me? You know what? I told a lie earlier. That's on me. I'm sorry. But I actually didn't forget to bring the duct tape. Stay still. I hate it when you do that. You ruin every good moment we have together. Do you realize that? Every single time I do something to better a relationship, you always do something stupid, like yell, when I specifically tell you not to. Every good memory, you freaking... Sorry, I know cursing isn't ladylike, but still. Do you know how frustrating that is for me? I let you speak, and then you do something stupid and make me take away your talking privileges. I clean your house for you, and you lock the doors. You lock the windows. You stay up all night with knives and guns waiting for me to come back. I know you wouldn't hurt me, but still, seeing you so angry at me, shutting me out of your life like that, do you know how much that hurts? It really does. You hurt me. And when I see you with that girl, that skank, it almost puts me over the edge. You've never seen me really angry before. And I would suggest you stop hanging out with that girl. Unless, I don't know, you want to see her disappear or something. Are you trying to say something? Duct tape, remember? But if you're asking me what I would do, you should use your imagination. Not that hard to figure out. Remember that girl who confessed her love to you the year that we had that class together? Do you remember how she disappeared? And how the police found her body about a week later? I think I would do something like that. Not saying that I did that thing to that girl, but I'm saying this time she won't be pretty enough for an open casket. So I'd think about that if I were you. Oh, don't cry. You don't have to pretend to care for that girl. I know how you really feel. It's okay to be yourself around me. You know that. Oh, you're still crying. That's so cute. You know, call me crazy, but while you were asleep, I looked through your text messages. I know. That's invading your privacy. But I think it would be okay just this once. And I saw that you made plans with that girl for tomorrow. And I know you're not the kind of person who'd like to lie. You're not the kind of person to say you were sick when you're not, right? So, how about that? I'm gonna spare you from the lie. How about, in light of your recent behavior, how about instead of me knocking you out, untying you, positioning you so you get all comfy, putting blankets on you so you don't get cold, how about this time I keep you tied up and I just knock you out again? That way you'll miss meeting her, right? But you won't have to lie. That'd be good, right? You don't have to lie to me by shaking your head. I know that's what you want to do. I know that's what you should do. And even if you don't want to, that's what you're going to do. I know, I can make some pretty tough decisions sometimes, but I think you'll thank me for it. Alright, honey, I'm gonna knock you out again now, because you're getting quite frantic, and quite frankly, the ropes are not that strong. I honestly wonder how you haven't broken through them before. Is it because you like being tied up? Don't worry, I won't kink shame you. Alright, I'm gonna go knock you out now. Stay still. I'm serious. Stay still. I'm gonna rupture your aortic artery if you don't stay still. Okay? Alright. It's a tiny prick. It doesn't hurt. Jeez. You could be such a baby.